Hi there, my name is Jennifer Hardwick and I'm a second year PhD student here at ICRI UWA. And this poster here is showing some work in a recently submitted paper of mine. So in this work, we use single dish H1 observations to determine the specific angular momentum for 564 nearby galaxies. These are from the XGAS sample, which stands for the Extended Galaxy Arecibo SDSS Survey, or XGAS, which is selected to be a relatively flat stellar mass distribution between 10^9 and 10^11.5. And what this means is that we have a large fraction of high mass early type galaxies, more so than you'd expect from a volume limited sample. We assume a constant velocity for all radii, which we take from the H1 width of the galaxies in this XGAS sample, and we assume a constant velocity profile when we calculate specific angular momentum for each of our galaxies. So shown here in the center is the stellar specific angular momentum stellar mass relation, and in the thin black line there I am showing the best fit to that relation, which we calculated using a Bayesian fitting tool called HyperFit. So the slope we determined for this relation was 0.47, which is actually the shallowest slope in the literature to date. And what we show in this work is that this slope is highly dependent on the mix of galaxy types that you have in your sample. And because our sample has a higher fraction of these high mass early type galaxies, we have our relation being pulled down at higher stellar masses because these early type galaxies have less angular momentum on average. So this is quite a bit shallower than previous works. One of those previous works is shown here in this blue line, which is the POSTI 2018 work, and they find a slope of 0.55 for their work. So we weren't only interested in looking at the slope of our relation, but we're also interested in what drives the scatter. So we believe this scatter to be intrinsic. It wasn't caused by measurement error. So what we did was, in this work, we looked at the relationship between the scatter of this relation and three parameters, Bolscher total ratio, H1 gas fraction, and specific star formation rate. And we found that the what drives the scatter in this relation here varied as a function of stellar mass. So for low stellar masses, and by that I mean galaxies that have a stellar mass less than 10 to the 10.25 solar masses, then the dominant driver of scatter was H1 gas fraction, where I've shown that in the plot in the top right panel. And you can see in that plot there the offset of each of the galaxies' specific angular momentum from what was predicted by the best fit relation. And you can see there's a quite strong correlation between the H1 gas fraction and this offset. For high stellar masses, which are the galaxies that are greater than 10 to the 10.25 solar masses, now the dominant driver is actually Bolscher to total ratio, which is slightly more dominant now than the H1 gas fraction for those higher stellar masses. So in the remainder of the paper, which I wasn't able to show here, we also look into how things change for disk components. So I'd encourage you to have a look at the paper when it comes in the archive soon. Hope you enjoyed it.